What's going on, everybody? Moneyball investing here. First things first, I was out last week in Iceland. I'm now back in the US, so no content last week. I've got a huge backlog this week of a bunch of videos I want to download. I just want to say thanks a ton to those who have been watching my videos, especially the Matterport videos and SoFi videos. Those are my highest viewed. I did one on Upstart as well, which is getting a bunch of views. Definitely want to give a shout out to my buddies Bird Law Trading and Occupy Investing. They've been huge supporters, pushing my content out there, and I really want to say thank you to them in particular. Let's get into this. I just initiated a position in GOOGL, and the thing is, I honestly didn't pay too much attention to them as far as the FAANG stocks. I was more interested in Apple, Facebook. Obviously, everybody knows I own Facebook. I was looking at Netflix for a while. I still look at them, but I don't have a position in them. I did not realize how incredible GOOGL, or Alphabet as they are known, as that's their corporate name. I'm stunned. I think this might be an unbelievable investment opportunity. I'm talking Amazon level growth. I think they are the best cash generating machine, and I think Microsoft is a close second. And so let's get into some numbers here, because when I really started digging in here, I was really blown away. I was astonished. So I have their shareholder letter from Q3, and we can see that they did $65 billion in Q3 revenue. That is up 41% year over year. I'll say that again. 41% at $65 billion in revenue. That's unbelievable. What really caught me is YouTube ads and Google Cloud. Let's go to YouTube first. They did $7 billion in YouTube ads, which this is, if we're going to talk about like the greatest M&A deals of all time, I think Amazon acquiring Kiva Systems takes the crown, flipping e-commerce and retail upside down, changing it forever. Then you've got Facebook acquiring Instagram. And I think Google acquiring YouTube might be the third best deal of all time if we were to rank them. I mean, think about this. This is basically pure margin for Google, this ad revenue. It goes right down to the bottom line. $7 billion, it's now a near run rate, $30 billion business line. And I almost say company, and here's why. I'm going to go over to Netflix. Netflix did $7.3 billion, $7.5 billion in quarterly revenue. And so far year to date, they've done basically $22 billion. Let's look at Netflix's growth rate. They've done $21.9 billion year to date. In the same time last year, they did 18.4. Netflix is growing at 19%, right? Now let's get back over to GOOGL. GOOGL has gone from, it has generated 20.2 billion revenue year to date, or YouTube rather, versus 12.9 the year before, 57%. This is insane. YouTube is basically the same size as Netflix, and it's growing at three times the rate. And obviously, there's some catalysts here. I mean, with COVID, there's this whole idea of the creator economy. Everybody's kind of becoming content creator now. I mean, look at me. I didn't start my channel, until during COVID, and there are other YouTubers that I follow that, did the same thing. So, is this growth rate sustainable? It's tough to say, but what we do know is that the quarterly revenue, the run rate revenue for YouTube is effectively the same as Netflix, and it's growing right now at 60% to Netflix's 20%. And this is just one business line. This is just one component of Google's revenue, and it's ultra high margin. Now let's get down to Google Cloud. Google Cloud, $5 billion in quarterly revenue. It's a run rate $20 billion business now. And when I think of, other cloud providers, obviously AWS and Microsoft come to mind. So let's check them out, right? AWS net sales for the 3 month ending September 30th, so for Q3, $16 billion, basically a a $50 billion business. So pretty much three times the size of Google Cloud. Microsoft, even bigger. You know, this is from Microsoft's quarterly press release. We delivered a strong start to the fiscal year. Microsoft Cloud generating $20.7 billion in revenue for the quarter. $21 billion for the quarter. That's almost $100 million, you know, run rate for the year. You know, not quite, but, you know, almost. So you've got Google doing $5 billion in quarterly revenue, run rate of 20. And you've got Microsoft doing $20 billion in one quarter and Amazon doing $16 billion. As well. So Google obviously has, you know, the smallest piece of the pie here out of the big three, but I actually view this as an opportunity. And here's why. Companies, like very large software companies, rely on multiple public clouds to run their infrastructure. And the reason why is they can't just go with AWS or just go with Microsoft. They'll get completely beat up on pricing. And it's also just not even, you know, logical to do something like that. So, you know, we'll go over here. Oops, switch my screen. This is Snowflake. As a lot of you know, Snowflake database management company run by a guy named Frank Slootman. He's like a legend in Silicon Valley. He was the former CEO of ServiceNow. Now he's running Snowflake. They had a huge IPO last year. It was like the biggest IPO. Definitely the biggest IPO last year. I think it may have even been the biggest IPO of all time. They are certainly like a hyper growth company. Their revenue growing through the roof. They're burning a lot of money. They're, you know, kind of spending money to make money right now, or to generate revenue rather. But anyway, getting off topic here. This is from the notes in their 10Q. Our platform, Snowflake platform, is built to be available on the infrastructure of third party public clouds such as AWS Azure, which is Microsoft, and GCP, Google Cloud Platform. So this is very interesting to me because I think that even though you've got AWS, which is nearly a $50 billion run rate business to Google's 20, so you know almost three times as large, and then you've got Microsoft, which is just in another, you know, just another universe compared to Amazon and Google. There's so much room to grow. And, you know, I know this is an overused phrase and I say it on my blog a lot, but data is truly the new oil. And with this, you know, sort of boom in data and, you know, this Internet of Things concept where, you know, there's going to just be constantly digitization and datafication of effectively everything, and everything needs to connect to each other. There's going to be a lot of room. There's going to be a lot of needs for these kinds of services. And there's a ton of room for Google to get even bigger. You know, for Google Cloud to become, you know, even more of a player in this space. But, you know, anyway, I just want to make a quick video today because I did not realize that YouTube, the size of YouTube and Google Cloud, I mean, these two businesses alone, these are just components of Google's revenue. Whereas Netflix, the entire thing is a streaming service. You've got YouTube, which is just one part of Google, effectively growing at three times the rate and is almost the same size in terms of just absolute dollars. Google Cloud, I think, has a lot of, greenfield or a lot of runway to grow. And it's just, you know, I don't know why I haven't been paying attention to this, but I'm glad that I did. I initiated a position last week. I will absolutely be buying more shares as I see fit. I'm a big believer in the management team as well. So that, you know, I think that has a lot to do with this type of growth. You know, something that's very interesting to me is if you go just to the very first page. Actually, this is the 10Q, not the press release, but Sundar Pichai, their CEO, you know, made a statement that, you know, when he became CEO 5 years ago, he outlined this vision to become, you know, sort of an AI-driven company. And I think a lot of the investments that they've made, we're starting to see pay off, kind of in real time here. And I think it's very interesting. So anyway, definitely let me know what you think. Let me know if you think this is risky or, you know, where it sits among the FAANGs, if you have a position in Alphabet or if you're, you know, not really feeling it. And definitely remember to like this video, share this video, subscribe to the channel. I will also include a link to my Substack where I do sort of deeper dives into the companies that I follow, mostly technology companies. It is totally free. So if you have a way to spend $0, this is a really good way to spend $0. Definitely subscribe to the Substack. I will share you know, some other videos on my channel that you can take a look at, so you can see, you know, kind of the companies that I'm interested in. And again, you know, if you could like, subscribe, share this video, it would really help me out. Thanks for watching.